How y'all doing? I want to welcome y'all to Strawberry Space, where we discuss transgender-related topics. So, hey, Strawberry Space, I want to tell you today that a lot of my videos have been getting copyrighted, claimed, and blocked. So, we're actually going to talk about a plethora of topics today for our videos. So, the first topic we have today and we're going to talk about is Saint Abby. Now, congratulations to St. Abby because as Zeus becomes more inclusive, it welcomes the LGBT community, mainly the T. I'm going to show you trans woman St. Abby and her Zeus submission for the Bad Girls Club audition video, as well as Tylan, who is a trans man with the Bad Boys Club. So take a look.
Royalty, I want a model for modern culture.
Get an X.
And I'm a savage just like you, Rolly.
For modern what?
I'm sorry. Normal culture.
Where's your name tag?
Baby, it's right here.
Well, turn it around.
I'm sorry. I'm not going to have anybody suck it from the bag, baby. I'm going to get this new fucking designer.
What's the name of her for her clothing collection?
Normal culture.
There we go.
I respect both of you beautiful women right here because you two taught me to be a respectful, humble bad bitch, unlike some people who are irrelevant who say, what? Suck it from the bag, baby. The only thing you're getting is designer pussy right here.
Get your wristband and get your pussy off the table. Thank you.
What's up, my girl?
Hi, I just broke up with my boyfriend so I can get my ass bleached. Thank you, Suki, for the inspo. And I got a designer pussy too, okay? This slit did not cost for free. First of all, I'm a bad bitch, they call me Abby. You like my new fit? Got it from all the transactions, because I'm a trans in action.
Y'all already know what it is.
Back up on the stage so they can see.
It's Miss Fox repping out of North New Jersey. I came all the way up here to get in this audition.
Check out.
Okay, so tell us, how did you secure this spot?
Okay, I'm a doll, and I'm here to represent.
You're definitely a doll.
And you're my doll.
Congratulations, I'm here to represent, and you're one step closer to securing that final spot. Congratulations.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm not a trans man. Probably the first one y'all have fucking seen all day.
You're a trans man?
No nigga behind me stepping like
I'm you look good.
I can out-rap any nigga here. I can out-rap
right
any
now.
Call it to the stage, 100 buns. Bag full of 50 hundreds, ain't no ones. Like it when that shit go automatic like my gun. Bust it open, pull up to the side, show me some. Work, bitch, twerk it till it hurt. Bitch, this ain't no motherfucking business. It's no fucking skirt, bitch.
Okay.
I got your racks in one pocket.
Man, get them hoes loose.
I'm gonna
Send me $300 right now.
Shout out to my boy Curtis, you heard me?
So this seems to be important because finally, due to exploitations in the past of several years ago, we get to finally represent ourselves and represent ourselves for us, by us, in the most positive way possible. Okay, move right on. The next topic is Nikita Dragon. Now, Nikita Dragon is a social media influencer and celebrity who is trans. She just got out of jail, and I'm going to play a snippet of her first post pre-back from incarceration on Instagram and a statement. So I know it's super small, you can't see, but due to contrary belief that she wasn't housed with the men in prison, she released a statement on Instagram via Nikita Dragon Verified saying, "I want to thank everyone for the outpouring of love and support recently. I've always been open with you guys about my journey, and there is an appropriate time for that. But oftentimes, the best way to heal and grow is to do so privately. So I will be off social media for a while in order to take care of my mental health and overall well-being. I love you all, and we'll see you soon." So moving on to the next topic, it looks like after the Shade Room of the Neighborhood talk confirmed that it was Chance the Rapper that liked Asian porn on Twitter, his story is kind of dying down, so we're about to move on to the next subject. And moving quite along, I'm just recapping, y'all. So this next one is Jonathan Porter. His name is Blueface. He is currently in incarceration right now, and he is advertising his new show also on Zeus with girlfriend Krishan, Crazy in Love. I'm going to show you a snippet of that theme trailer, and it comes out every Sunday. You have to subscribe to Zeus to see it. But it's not really him that has the trans-related topic on their mind. It is his mother. She went on the Tasha K show, and I want you to hear what she had to say.
I understand you at first, because you were so weird. But the good weird, though, I fucked with you from the first day. I don't know how we got here, but I'm glad we got here.
You know when you fuck with somebody.
We have none other than the East Valley League champion out here in these streets.
Let's go!
I want to know how you guys would describe your love. Some say it's toxic, some say it's super real.
You can shine, you rock. Toughest bitch in the world.
Let this shit flourish, let's go up.
People are like, they're toxic and they shouldn't be together. What do you have to say to that?
Somebody need to hug this girl and let her know everything is gonna be all right.
The thing that's happening to build your career is crippling his.
I just asked you a fucking question, bro.
I don't give a fuck.
You
fake
playing with my dick. What are you talking about?
You're a fucking criminal.
You know she gonna be on go, and you know she on go.
I'm a fog.
Because but everybody around them
look how quick
is making...
we look how quick we forget. Now, if that was a situation where it was a man, there was a woman, and the transgender thing, we would be all... Look how quick we change our perspectives when it comes to neutral gender. Like, how do we... We can't... They can play sports with us as men, but
what
how
does transgender come in at?
I'm just saying, like, how do we... If a woman acts like she's a man...
I just said they're both beating each other's asses.
But the first thing you said was...
He beat her ass. Well, he is, and he... Listen, as...
He didn't beat her ass until she beat his ass.
Well, either way, because they have people...
But that's even...
To just... Because he's Blueface, he got money, he got access...
No, because if that would have went to court, she would have got in trouble. If you hit a police officer the way you hit him, you going to jail, and that police officer is allowed to put you down as a man. Yes or no?
I feel that your son...
Is that true or not?
Your son is going to continue the behavior because you continue to make excuses for him, and you just did it right now.
I'm not making excuses for it. I'm just saying...
Because that's your baby.
I'm not going to put my hands on a man that way and not expect for it to come back in return. And if we keep telling these young ladies it's okay to go up and punch men, they're going to punch police officers and we're going to have more police brutality. And everybody needs to respect each other, whether we're a woman or man, period.
So we can agree to disagree. So if it comes down to him disrespecting you or his girlfriend's disrespecting you.
I tell my daughter all the time, if you hit a man, he's going to hit you back. You cannot do that.
First of all, We're just going to agree to disagree in this and go get some food. Okay.
So she was obviously meaning she, Miss Carlissa, Blueface's mother, using transgender rhetoric to deflect from the situation between the relationship between Krishan Rock and her son Blueface. In a recent Yahoo News article, it also states that she is refusing to pay Blueface's bail. So I'm moving right along, and listen, trans men and women of Strawberry Space, I want to apologize in advance. I know that my videos usually be lengthy and you know, more informative. But I'm zooming by this because it literally is over 10 topics I am really covering. I'm just trying to really compensate and give you a synopsis on this because in the middle of Trans Awareness Week, there is so much to talk about. So I'm just briefly going over like an overview of everything. So the next person we have here is Dr. Elijah. He is a trans man. And recently he had his showing of his book. So I'm going to play some pictures of that and a snippet really of, you know, what the book entails. And it is a children's book, by the way. So take a look.
Elijah Nicholas holds a doctorate degree, 3 master's degrees, and spent over half of his life in the U.S. military, retiring as a senior officer in 2012. But he says success paled in comparison to a life not true to his core values. In 2018, Dr. Nicholas transitioned from female to male and is now dedicating his life to educating and inspiring others. And his new children's book, Madoodle, tells the story of Uncle Pete, who was once Aunt Mary. And we welcome Dr. Elijah Nicholas with us this morning. Good to have you here. So before we get to the book, which I'm looking forward to talking about, tell us a little bit about your work in the military, where you spent half of your life, your career, and then transitioning after you left the service.
Thank you so much for having me today, Melanie. I appreciate being here. Yes, so I spent half of my life, over half of my life in the military. I joined the military when I was 17 years old. I was a young private when I left home for the armed forces, and my mother had to sign the papers. That's how young I was.
Of a boy named Penelope. Let's check out this must-have book about black trans boy joy. We first meet Pen, who goes by Penelope. Penelope identifies beautifully and differently. And through their own experiences, they discover that they are masculine presenting. And with the help of their mother and their father, Pen gains the confidence to discover who they are, identify and express themselves confidently. This beautiful children's book is about identity, individuality, but also family, and how to educate yourself the same way Penn's family did to better support their loved one and to be a stronger family unit. This beautiful story about Penn's journey adds much color to any story time. Definitely check it out.
So I'm not really sure how to pronounce her name, but this is the first wife of Dwayne Wade. I think her name is Savon Funches. So this is Zaya Wade's biological mother. So, you know, Dwayne Wade has another family he remarried and had another child with, Gabrielle Union. But Zaya, who transitioned when she was 12, she's 15 now, allegedly is being accused by her mother because Savon is saying that Dwayne, because he's a, you know, retired NBA player and it's not really happening like that. She's saying that Dwayne pressured Zaya into transitioning for LGBT brand deals and more relevance.
Dwayne Wade's ex-wife, Savon, thinks money is the motivating factor for him pushing their transgender daughter, Zaya, to legally change her name and gender. In August, Dwayne filed a petition with the court on behalf of Zaya to recognize her as a female. Savon filed an objection because she believes Dwayne is pressuring the child for financial gain and violating the custody agreement by not consulting her. In court documents, Savon claims Dwayne already has deals in place and admitted to her that money was partially the reason to file the petition. Savon said she's not fully on board with the gender and name change and she wants Zaya to turn 18 before making the decision for herself without Dwayne's influence. According to The Blast, a hearing is set for December where a judge will make the final decision. What do you think about Savon's claims?
So since I'm not a mother or a parent, I really can't speak on personal experience from the Zaya Wade situation. But I really hope that they all get it together and at least consult Zaya's feelings into the mix, because children have voices too. Okay, so moving on. The next topic I will bring up is City Girl member JT getting praise from the transgender community from her transgender reference use in the lyrics of her TikTok snippet for her new song, No Bars.
Real big dog, bitch, you a scrappy dude doing all that wifey shit, knowing he don't fuck with you. Poster girl pussy in your nigga dreams. I'ma hold it, send me bust whoever in between. Gangsta bitch, JT Medellin. Haven't heard from the ops, yeah, they ain't said a thing. I be damn, nigga, you know who I am, nigga. Long way from cracking cars and pulling scams, nigga. Bitches on my dick, pretty like a transgender. Sit this pussy on his chin in a chinchilla. 50 flows up, can't hop out my coupe unless I lift the doors up. I'm a real big.
And those excerpts were from Real Reality Gossip on TikTok, This Happened, Breakbeat, The Jasmine Brand, and Instagram's Gay Magazine. So the next topic I have to bring up is Jasmine Davis. Now, Jasmine Davis is a transgender actress, and she's known mostly for her role on The Chi, saying that she was mistreated by the Disney Network. So this excerpt is going to be via the Tea Time Network, and I'm going to play that excerpt right now.
And I also have receipts. I have receipts of me constant complaining about treatment, how I felt like I was treated by some employees on Disney from the Disney productions. I have receipts. I have recordings of me complaining about the treatment. I have receipts of the so-called people still wanting to work with me after I denied them of their proposal. So I'm just at my wit's end, you know, like they had no other thing. They can't go around say bad things about me. I'm not one of those people who sleep with people on set. I don't treat people mean. So they had to use a political stunt, which don't even matter. You know, no one cares about that. A political stunt, which is not even the truth, you know?
Now, this story I really need some support on, because this is a really touching story. The next topic is going to be about a girl, Leilani Muniz. She is a trans activist. I don't know what possessed her to solicit someone in a park, but I'm going to play the excerpts from the police, the Grindr chat notifications, and all of that right now.
And he actually confirmed, and I told him we're not doing that. He said, okay.
Dude, I got the chat logs. You talking to me the whole time. Leilani, don't walk home. I know where you live.
All right.
Let's just have a simple conversation.
Exactly.
Let's have an educated conversation, because we both know what you do for a living.
What do I do for a living?
What you do for transgenders.
What do I do?
Well, you're a spokeswoman for them, right?
No, not spokeswoman for transgender
women. No? You don't, you don't run the organization? No? So it's not you think I don't know about you now? Come on.
So what is the problem?
What is the problem? What is it doing today? Is it illegal or legal?
I'm not actually, it's legal because
it's legal? So if we was to call the cops, what would they tell us, Leilani?
Why? What is the purpose of this?
Well, the same way you spread awareness, I spread awareness.
About what?
You just told me you watched the TV show.
Exactly, but I'm not.
Bingo! I spoke.
She ran into your house.
All right, just let's move past that.
Yeah.
When was
this was from started October 4th.
This
is till now.
In particular was.
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh huh. Yesterday she wanted to. She paused it off, then she did it for today. She wanted me to go to the house. And she's an advocate. Listen.
Actually,
no. Nope. You said somebody else was talking. Who is it then?
Wait, can I get him?
Come on, man. Stop playing.
So our next topic up is Scott. Now, Scott is an adult entertainer. He is best known for his alleged 11 inches, and his porn name is kept secret. And I'm going to try to play a little bit of snippet of what I can on Twitter and tell you how he ties into this transphobia rhetoric when he meets said collaboration other actress Brandy Bugatti.
I don't care if these bitches don't like me, because like...
Now, I know trans men and trans women star race space, that was a very short snippet, but that's really all I can show, because when she opened the door, he was naked. So these were the transphobic comments that they were making in his comment section. So I guess his Twitter fan base and OnlyFans subscribers were mad, feeling like they lost a fellow homosexual black man to their community, because now he was swinging more toward the heterosexual community since he was having sex with a trans woman. So I know it's little, y'all can't read it, but he said, "There's been ignorant comments about my interest in filming with trans women on this page. Negative, rude, or disrespectful comments of any kind will not be addressed and you will get blocked." He also says, "The porn that I create is a form of entertainment for the masses, gay, straight, etc. I like the art. My job is to give the viewers the best sexual experience that I can. Sex has no bounds and I will not be put in a box. Watch if you want, and if you don't, then leave." And I believe this also triggered him to as well further his collaboration and open his mind to do another collaboration with female-to-male star Jamal Phoenix. So here he is pictured, Scott with T.S. Madison, so it's nice to know that he is a proud ally to the trans community. So speaking of T.S. Madison, she was just recently on the Don't Call Me White Girl podcast. And just recently, she did another podcast episode after her with the next topic we have, Just Hilarious.
That you would like to share with these motherfucking people.
Yes. Okay, so it's a cliffhanger. So this guy's a celebrity.
Blue check in the DM.
Yup, this nigga DM'd me and wanted to fly me out so I could fuck him.
In the ass?
Yes, but not with a dildo. This nigga thought I was a man. He really did think I was he thought I was a transgender. He thought I was trans.
Won the competition, didn't she?
He was very
drunk. What the fuck is wrong with him?
Very direct with it. I was like, this is crazy. Wow.
Yes. I would like to know this nigga's name later. Mm-hmm. Woo! Let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. If he made the deal seem pretty juicy, you know, let's say you single and, you know, he maybe offered you $100,000, would you have put a strap on and fuck them in the ass?
Absolutely. What do you mean?
Oh. Wow.
Girl, yeah. I was trying to go find a dick. And it was money involved. Have you ever used a strap on somebody? No, I was trying to practice all this. But I think I was more insulted because he thought I was a man. So I was like, fuck him. Bitch.
Yeah, bitch.
But when I seen like the wager.
So it just goes to show trans men and trans women of strawberry space, be careful who you share your energy with and who you be in environments with, because just weeks ago she was just laughing and kicking with T.S. Madison. Now she's talking anti-LGBT with Jess Hilarious. So just keep that in mind. So the last and final topic is the unfortunately late Shanquella. And we're going to talk about how she, even though she's a cisgender biological woman, relates to being on the docket of a trans topic. So many of us were given this information of Shanquella Robinson going on her trip with friends. And a lot of people thought that one of the friends that assaulted her, I can't play the video, was trans. And I'm going to show you, they even lied and photoshopped a picture to try to insinuate that this was a male to female individual. Whole time, this was another biological woman. So a word got back to T.S. Madison that the girl was said to be trans,
But was it trans? T.S. Madison tweeted, now why would y'all even start that kind of lie on a trans person and you people immediately believe that bogus shit? That was not true. No trans woman beat Shanquella Robinson to death. It was one of her own. You people immediately ran with that lie. She also tweeted, y'all are so funny, so now all of a sudden today you started accepting trans women as women. It's the pick and choose what I say that offends you for me. So y'all, between the neighborhood talk and the shade room, they took that little piece of one of her own and y'all, they were eating her up. So that concludes all of the treacherous week in Trans Awareness Month, unfortunately, of the trans related topic. So in conclusion, y'all stay safe. Focus on how society views you as a trans man and woman, and I will definitely talk to y'all later. So this has been Strawberry Space, and thank you.